Hello, in this video I'm going to be going over a little bit more advanced setup on the Ubiquiti NanoBeam AC 5AC Gen 2 Wi-Fi bridge. So it's been a little while since the last video, I apologize for that. I haven't been able to work on this for numerous reasons, but we left off that I had set up two of these NanoBeams to each other in a bridge configuration. Since that time, I've installed them. So I mounted them to two buildings and then I aligned them. So if you go on the app, there's an alignment utility and it will beep and you can move the antennas around until they are aligned properly. And at that point, I had the connection between the two buildings. I've also, in the last video, I called them home and barn, I think it was, and I now call those home and remote. That's the name I settled on for these. So in this video I'm going to be using the web interface. So on the app you'll see it'll have IP addresses for the two Wi-Fi bridges. So I have those here on 192.168.7.3 and 7.4, and I have those two pulled up and they are each in a tab of my web browser. So also I want to point out that if you like these videos, I'll put a link in the description to these Wi-Fi bridges, and if you buy them through that link, it's my Amazon affiliate link, I get a little cut and it doesn't cost you anything extra. And also put a link down there to a playlist of any other Ubiquiti videos I have. So when you put this IP address into your web browser, you'll get on a lot of web browsers, you'll get a little message saying that this may not be secure. Well, there's a what they call self-signed certificate on there. You just need to accept it and then you can get right in. You typically don't want to do that if it's like a website over the internet, but this is your, you know, your own local equipment. So when you log in, you'll get to a page that looks like this. This is the dashboard. If you look on the left here, it says we're on the dashboard. There's also settings and Air Magic. This is on the home. On the remote, you'll see dashboard and settings. You won't see the Air Magic over there. So look at the dashboard. We have the local and remote, which we call home and remote. And it gives some stats on these. You know, it tries to guess how far away they are, although I don't think mine are quite that far away. And you can see signal strengths, things like that. Lots of stats here. I'm not going to focus too much on this. I'll pop down here to Air Magic. So with Air Magic, it will show you, I may not use all this, the proper terminology, but it'll show you like the frequency spectrum. So you can see where the bandwidth is used in your area. So this shows some open frequencies here that it's recommending. And you can change this here to like your channel width. So the higher the channel width, the faster you go, but also potentially have more interference. So I don't think I have much interference here, so I went with 80. If you stick with a lower one, like if you need reliability, you might want to go with a lower one. So I went with 80, but this is just kind of a tool you can use. I'll go back to the settings and we'll see where this is used. So I'm going to revert changes here. But if you wanted to, you could click this. And then when you go into settings, you'll see this channel width, the control frequency list, and then center frequency. If you click that, the center frequency will select one of these. So I just have it set to auto. So, and you know, if you have more experience than me or suggestions on this, on using this equipment, go ahead and put that in the comments, or if anyone has any questions, put them in the comments, and certainly read through the comments after watching this in case anyone has any advice that I don't cover in here. Maybe I'm doing something completely wrong. Hopefully they'll people will add things in the comments. But I'll just go over this here. We set up, so right now I'm on home, and it seems like most of the settings at this point you tweak will be on the home Wi-Fi antenna. So we set up the wireless mode here to access point PTP. If you remember on the remote, we set that up as station PTP. So The SSID, you can change that here. You'll want to change that on both at the same time. And I would think you would want to probably change it on the remote here. Save and then change it on the home one so it can sync up properly. If you change it on here and not the other one, I think you'll lose your connection, unless I'm wrong, but I don't see how that would work if they're on different SSIDs. So down here is the channel width, and we looked at that on the Air Magic. I think this defaulted to 20. After the last video, I think it was on 20. So I wanted to get a higher speed, so I upped it to 80. The control frequency list in megahertz, I'm not completely sure how this works. I think you can just select the frequencies you allow, maybe. If someone knows, please put a comment. But that was off by default. And then the center frequency I have set to auto. And then this calculate EIRP limit. I get, from what I understand, this keeps you from upping your power too much, such that you run into a situation where your setup is illegal. So it's probably a good idea to keep that on. Then the output power here, what I did, and I'm in easy line of sight. I mean, I can visually easily see the second antenna. So I put this all the way down. I like the idea of starting with this lower and then upping it on the output power, because you don't want to have more power than you need. So imagine you're talking to someone in a room, and maybe they're 2 foot away from you, or let's say 3 foot or a meter, if that's how you do your measurements. You really don't want to yell at them. You want to use the proper volume for your voice. So the output power, typically when two people are talking, they'll talk as quiet as they can, but still be heard. Understood by the other person. And it's the same way with this. So I put the power all the way down, and then if I needed to up it, I would do that. But I didn't want to start out having it full bore on and then have to lower it. So I like to start low and add it up. That way you're not drowning out other people's Wi-Fi setups. So then we have the auto adjust distance and distance. This is recommended to be on. I'm not sure exactly what that does. There's a max transmit data rate here I've set to auto, and this data rate module I have set to auto, or to default. So the next thing we have here is the security key. So you can change your password here, your Wi-Fi password. So this is the one when someone picks the Wi-Fi SSID, it's the password they type in. Of course, this is a bridge, so same goes with changing the SSID. You'd want to change this password on the remote and then change it on the home one. So there's this wireless network protection, and it says this feature protects the AirMax network against deauthorization attacks. I have this off, but I may turn this on. I'm not going to turn on during this video because I don't want to potentially knock this thing off while I'm trying to shoot a video. But you could turn that on, and that is also, that's not here. So this is what I was talking about earlier. You have more things you're setting here. So this, you just set the pre-shared key. On the home side, you can turn this on, and then you can have Mac ACL or access control list. And we can go here, and you can punch in the Mac address of the remote. And that's probably not a bad idea either. If you go over here, I'm not sure exactly where it's showing the MAC address. It may actually be printed on the antenna itself, or you can look it up. So that keeps it, so anything with it, that, you know, that shouldn't be your security system, but it probably doesn't hurt to have it on. And these are the signal LED thresholds. So this, there are LEDs on the unit itself, and this is the threshold for when they light up. So you could use those LEDs to help aim it or things like that. I think a lot of people are probably gonna just use a smartphone or something. And then this advanced, I'm not completely sure what these settings do. I just left them alone. So if we go to network here, network's in bridge mode, configuration mode's in simple, and then the IP address is DHCP. So I did set up, I punched in the IP address of this in my browser. I have this set up in my router to always give these bridges these IP addresses, so it doesn't change each time. I don't have to use any kind of like discovery utility to find them. I know they're going to be at that. So you could also just set a static here and give it a static IP. I prefer to use DHCP and then configure it in the router itself. So then you have STP, which is spanning tree protocol, management VLAN, audio IP aliasing. I've left all these to default off. So if we go to services, first up here, you have the Ubiquiti Network Management System. I have not used this. This is like their centralized management system. There's this ping watchdog. So you can have it ping some system. You could have it ping a router or something. And if the ping fails to go through, one second, let me go back over to here. So so I'm on the remote side now. The network there, pretty much the same. Except for auto IP aliasing is on. I'm not completely sure what that does, but I don't think I've changed that. So let me go to services over here. So so now we're in the same place on both. You have this ping watchdog. You can type an IP address into ping. And if it cannot ping that, it will reboot the Wi-Fi access point after so many pings or tries. So if this like on the remote side, if you don't have access to that directly and you don't have an easy way to reset that, this could be kind of handy. You could have this ping the router on the home side, and if it can't get across that wireless link, it will reboot itself. So that's what this ping watchdog does. I have access to both of these, so I can easily just go and plug it if I need to. But as of right now, sorry, I'm jumping around here. If I go to the dashboard, I think if I scroll down here, my uptime on the home one has been set 74 days, and I did reboot the remote one a couple days ago, but they've been very reliable. So, so that ping watchdog might be useful for you know, helping with reliability if you have issues with that. So then you have the SNMP agent. I don't use SNMP on my networks. You have this web server. I think this is the same setting on both. Yep. So web server, it says secure connection HTTPS, and I like to use that as on. So we're not using unencrypted connections. That's the same on the home and remote. And then you have SSH server. So this, you can SSH into the access points and modify things or reboot them or whatever. So I have those on them both. Then here you have the Telnet server. So you can turn on Telnet. That's kind of older. It does kind of the same thing as SSH, but it's unencrypted, so I don't like to use that. And then it says Mac Telnet server. I'm not sure exactly what this is, but I assume it has something to do with Telnet, and I don't really want to use Telnet. So we have the NTP client. So this is the network time protocol. So right now it connects to the NTP.org pool. So this keeps the time set properly on your device. There's the dynamic DNS. You know, for my application where I'm using a bridge, I don't really need the dynamic DNS. So this is to set up a DNS name for people who don't use a static IP. But that, I don't really see why you'd use that with a bridge. And then system log is on. And then I have device discovery is on, CDP off. Let's see what I have on this. The same things there. I'm not sure. I may be able to turn device discovery off. So, and then if we go over to system here, I think most of this is the same. It's a little different here. It has the firmware version, the build number, check for updates. So you can hit this to check for any firmware updates. You can change the device name here. You can turn on PoE, pass-through, air views on. The management radio on startup. I have this turned off now since I have it started up. Otherwise, when you restart it, the management radio will come on. Then you can connect to it with a smartphone on the management radio and make a configuration change. So if this screws up, you can just start from scratch too if you want. And you can reset it by pushing a button on the back of the access point, or on the PoE injector also has a button. So you know, if this is on a big tower, you don't have to climb up there to push that button. And let's see, we have start date. This is so you can put a start date in here. I guess this is when you deployed it. Then we have time zone. I guess this time zone isn't set here. You can set the time zone. I'm surprised I didn't set this already, but I'll change that later. Then you have the administrator account and password, and you can put in your latitude, longitude, device height, and the remote side, same settings. Okay. Down here, you can reboot the device. You can reset to the factory defaults. You can backup configuration. This is probably a good idea. Like I was saying, if something screws up, you could wipe it out and start over. Well, if you have a backup, especially if you're making big changes, you can backup the configuration, then reload it in later. So let's see what else we have here. Down in the corner, left-hand corner, you have a log, so you can diagnose any problems. Up here on top, we have the Ubiquiti Network Management System, which I don't use. And then we have this tools. So this has AirView. This is like a spectrum analyzer, it looks like. We have alignment. So this alignment, there's an app, there's a part of the app that does this too, which I think is probably handier than this, but you can use this to like aim your antennas at each other. And then there's an audio thing here. I don't think you can hear it because I have headphones on, but this will beep as you're aiming it. So if you have your laptop, say on the ground, and you're up on a ladder on top of a building and you can hear it, you can kind of listen for it to be in alignment as the tone changes. So you can use that to help align the antennas. Discovery here. Not sure exactly what all these tools are for. Your site survey, you can ping, trace route, speed test. Constellation shows some kind of a map thing. I'm not sure what that is. But and then you can do speed test. So this is kind of, I just wanted to go over this because it's essentially what I did. After I did the initial setup, I went through here and went through these settings and set them up. Like I said, if you have any suggestions on anything that you think I could do better, please put them in the comments. Or if you have any questions about any of these settings, I can maybe answer, or maybe someone in the future will read it and answer it for you. So I would like to thank you for watching. Again, I have a link in the description to these products on Amazon, and I'll put a link in the description to my playlist. And thanks for watching. Goodbye.